I'm joined now by the Conservative MP Mark Reckless, who sits on the Home Affairs Committee and supports the government's campaign, and also by Rita Chadder from the Refugee and Migrant Forum of East London. Rita Chadder, can you explain to Mark Reckless why this campaign is so offensive?
Mark, it's simply offensive because it targets people. It makes it quite clear that immigrants aren't wanted in this country, whether they're legal or illegal. The campaign is in English. It really makes a mockery of saying that London is a multicultural city.
Well, it targets illegal immigrants. You say it targets legal and illegal, but it doesn't. What matters is not ethnicity, but legality, and people who are not here legally, who are illegal immigrants, who don't have a right to appeal, who should be in a different country. I think it's right to ask them to go back to that country.
Mark, what does an illegal immigrant look like?
Well, there's a variety of different types of illegal immigrants.
So you could spot one on the streets of Brent or in Redbridge or in Barkingham Dagenham, could you?
No, not directly. I think usually it's intelligence-led in this area. And when we see
Well, this wasn't very intelligence-led, was it?
Well, let me give an example. When you see the border agency actually crack down on some of the employers employing illegal immigrants, Rita's organisation supported a campaign, Hands Off My Workmate. On her website, her organisation's website, they describe employers who cooperate with the border agency as grasses. And this is publicly funded by Labour councils.
But it's the use of that phrase, isn't it? Go home. Anyone who grew up, any immigrant or non-white person who grew up in Britain in the 60s, 70s and 80s has heard that phrase as a term of racist abuse. And the government's put it on a poster.
But I think society has moved on since then. I think what
has
we
it?
Saw
How
was
do you know?
What I thought was Central and Eastern European immigration that we saw from 2003 or so was I think that broke the link between race and immigration. I actually find in my constituency that many immigrant communities are as strongly against this. A lot of people who come in illegally undercut people in the labour market. They compete, and those who suffer are those who are competing with them in the labour market. It's right that we have to crack down on illegal immigration rather than just tolerating having more than a million plus.
Haven't you got to join the government in tackling illegal immigration rather than complaining about the campaign?
No, absolutely not. I mean, there is a place for actually helping people to return if they choose to do so. Those schemes already exist. You do not need a massive billboard going around the streets of London promoting it.
Let's go to this breaking news tonight, which is this imagery from a London station of immigration officers, Kensal Green Station, and the allegation is that these officers have been basically targeting people, presumably racial profiling, and asking them about their immigration status. Is this what we're supposed to be doing?
Well, I don't think people should be targeted on the basis of race, not least because it's not a good way to deal with a problem, because the problem of illegal immigration is mainly visa overstayers and is across all different ethnicities.
But you want immigration officers on public transport stopping people and saying, where's your passport? I mean, isn't that the kind of thing people get prosecuted for in this country?
Well, I want to see that the government tackling illegal immigration, as well as this campaign. What we should do is we should target particularly employers of illegal immigrants, but also landlords who are supplying the housing. We've given our immigration officers the right discretion back. We've got them doing interviews, and we've actually got, when reports come into police of illegal immigration, we're trying to actually do something about it, rather than just sweep all this under the carpet and ignore it, as we saw for years and years under the Labour government.
Of these images that we're just guessing from
this is something that goes on in London all the time. You've co-opted the police into an enforcement role around immigration. That's not their task. They're there also to support victims. We're changing the whole dynamic around the immigration debate to enforcement, and saying that people aren't welcome here anymore.
But that is what the public seem to want, isn't it? I mean, every opinion poll that all these political parties have taken for the last couple of years have said immigration is a massive issue. But all the political parties have moved round to tackling, you know, this Labour's being tough on immigration and everything.
Except the Lib Dems. Your partners in coalition are
very
lukewarm, well, very anti the whole issue as well. They are showing some real civic leadership on the issue.
Is Lyndon Crosby behind this? This is the kind of thing he did in Australia, and he's doing it here as well, isn't he?
No, I don't think he is. We've said we're going to cut immigration from hundreds of thousands to tens of thousands a year, and we're trying to deal with this massive backlog of illegal immigrants who are in the country and actually change the culture so it's no longer acceptable for employers just to have those people competing unfairly with those who are regulated who are paying their taxes. We want to enforce the law and ensure that we only have the number of people coming into the country that we're properly able to integrate.
Mark Reckless, Rita Chadder, thank you both very much.